In this case, we focus on white box testing. So consider now this other function called fun. And let's assume that we want to test this function without having a specification, so without knowing exactly what it needs to do, but just by looking at the code. So what we will try to do probably in this case is to try to just execute all the statements in the function. And notice that we'll talk extensively of what does it mean to do white box testing later on in the next two classes. So if that's our goal, if our goal is to cover all the statements, any input will really do. So any test case will execute all statements in the code and will have a complete white box testing coverage for the program. Imagine that I now give you a specification for this function. And what the specification says is that this function inputs an integer parameter, param, and returns half of its value if param is even and its value unchanged otherwise. That means if param is odd. So looking at this specification, we can clearly see that the function fun works correctly only for even integers, and it doesn't work for odd integers because it computes half of the value of the parameter and returns it every time, no matter what param is. So this is a case in which white box testing could easily miss the problem because, as we said, any input will exercise the code. It's just by chance that we could reveal one that revealed the problem in the code. Conversely, if we were to work in a black box manner, typically, looking at the specification, we will select at least one odd and one even input number to exercise all of the specified behavior, and we will find the problem right away. So these two examples are just very small examples, and they're kind of stretched. But these kind of issues occur on a much bigger scale and in much more subtle ways in real-world software. And so what these examples do is to show you how black box and white box testing are really complementary techniques. So in the next two lessons, we will explore these two types of techniques in detail. We will see different kinds of white box and black box testing, and we'll talk about their strengths and limitations.